Namaskar.
Namaskar.
I am extremely happy to be introducing to you a really important topic for your health. It is the number one major cause of disease, and when you get a handle on this, it's going to become your number one source of health. I'll be telling you exactly what this habit is after just a little bit, but I want to say, first of all, that when you are able to follow this change in habit, and we will give a very good system that you can gradually enable yourself to do it, to empower yourself to do it, then your body is going to feel much lighter, much more flexible, much better energy, and almost any disease that you are facing, you'll be able to eliminate it or at least very much decrease it. This is an easy, doable system. We're going to be talking about one single habit. And the funny thing is that when people try to guess what is this worst common habit which causes disease, they can't get it. They will guess alcohol, they'll guess cigarettes, they'll guess overeating, they will guess all kinds of things, not getting proper sleep, not getting proper exercise, and it's a fact that all of these are contributors to disease, but it is not the single most important bad habit. So we will be elaborating on that in this video, and then Ramesh and I are going to be doing quite a number of videos over the next few weeks, and we'll be speaking about other really important habits. Water drinking. We'll be speaking about what kind of food you should eat. This is real simple changes in your diet, which will bring a big effect that's related to alkaline food, but it's a different kind of a definition than you've heard before. And we'll speak of the quickest way of healing disease, and we will explain in detail about how to detox, but in really simple, excellent cleansing ways. Now, I want to introduce Ramesh Bionis. He is the director and founder of the Prama Wellness Center, which is one of the centers in our chain of, in our network of yoga wellness centers around the world and Anamarga centers. He's had countless programs, essentially almost every week for many years now, with so many patients and with extremely good results. And I'm so happy to be sharing this platform together with Ramesh Bionis. Ramesh.
Thank you, Dada, for that introduction and the wonderful leading up to this issue that we're going to talk about. But first, I would like to introduce Dada Dharmavedananda, who is actually my teacher. And he is the founder of the system of wellness centers, and he has opened up 7 centers in different parts of the world. He has trained hundreds of graduates in this system of detox, and he has had thousands of clients around the world with up to 90% success rate. So a wonderful track record. He has over 40 years of experience. What is important to know and remember is that the issue that we're going to explain today is the number one cause of disease. And why changing this habit is important is because it has a connection between the digestive system and the immune system. Scientists today are well aware that immunity and digestion are connected. 70% of the immune system is within the digestive system. And so the habit that we're talking about is important because when we're not following this habit, then fermentation starts in the digestive system, and that fermentation creates negative bacteria, and that creates a weakening of the immune system. And then when the immune system is weakened, then disease sets in. In other words, as it is said in many natural healing systems, the disease often starts in the digestive system or is connected with that, and then it migrates to other parts of the body. So this is the number one cause, as Dada was talking about, that we're going to explain today. So what is this? What is this number one cause? Dada?
Yeah. Well, I will expose it right now. You see, whenever I meet people who seem not to have perfect habits, maybe they eat meat, maybe they drink, maybe they smoke, and they're more than 40, 45 years old, but they're healthy, means it seems not to fit. I always ask them the same question, and I always get the same answer. And the question that I ask is, do you ever eat between meals? And they always say, oh, no, never. And then I ask them, and do you ever eat when you're not hungry? No, never. Why should I do that? And this is the bad habit of which we are going to speak in detail. It is the habit of eating when one is not hungry. This is the hugest, the biggest cause of disease that people face. And it is not, and you may think when you hear it that you won't be taking snacks or that it's too drastic a change to make. And I would agree with you. Except that we will give a system that will make it very easy. Ramesh, before I give that system, can you comment something further?
You know, some people then will say, well, I'm always hungry. I always feel hungry. So why is that? Why do people feel always hungry? As we mentioned, eating when not hungry is the number one problem. And what does that cause? It causes acidity and gases in the stomach, and those gases will give us a feeling of being hungry. Now, there is one simple practice we can do to test that, and that is to drink a cup of water. If we have a sensation of hunger, we drink a cup of water, we wait about 10 minutes, and then if there is no hunger, then it was a demon hunger. And so this is a very simple system of testing that practice.
Right. Okay, now what is the system that we're going to use? System is that if you, for example, let's say you're taking three snacks a day. You're taking some cake, you're taking some nuts, maybe you have some kind of, you're taking some milk or some yogurt or whatever. It might be a health, so-called healthy diet, healthy snacks, but still a little bit heavy. So you could first shift at least one of those snacks, shift it into juicy fruit. For example, watermelon or papaya or pineapple or grapes or kiwis or ripe peaches or any of these fruits. If you just eat one or two of those types of fruits when you're feeling hungry, you'll see, or when you want to eat, maybe you're not feeling hungry at all, rather, but you feel like eating, you want to have a snack, so you take that, it will affect you less harmfully than other snacks would. When you become accustomed to that with one single snack, then you can now apply it for another snack, the juicy fruit. And when that's comfortable, you apply it for all your snacks. When that's comfortable, then you shift to smoothies. Smoothie means making it only with these same kind of juicy fruits, blended fruits. Now one snack has become blended fruits, other snacks are, you're still chewing the fruit. Now when you're comfortable with that, now you adapt it to your second snack and then to all your snacks. And then you follow the same system. When you're comfortable with that, now you move into juice. For one snack, and then another snack, and then all the snacks, when you're comfortable with that, then you shift to diluted juice. When you're comfortable of that with one snack, then you make it the other snacks, step by step. And when you're comfortable with that, you can, if necessary, you can then shift that to lemon water with just a titch of natural salt in it. Lemon water and water, and now you've hit the point. You're not taking any snacks at all, and you're feeling so much better. This is the system that works extremely well. Ramesh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Drinking water is the cure for this problem. Now, this goes against a lot of the advice that people are getting from their doctor, because when someone has hyperacidity or ulcer, the doctor is often saying, well, then you should eat, then you should snack. This is a very common suggestion. But as Dada explained, it doesn't work, because this again will just keep this condition as a chronic condition. And then, of course, another very common way to try to treat this, so to speak, is by taking antacids. And that also will not treat this problem, because it basically just suppresses the acidity. So you feel temporarily better, but it will not cure the issue. So some more natural methods that are better and healthier to use is to simply boil potatoes and create a little starchy liquid in potato water or rice water, boiling the rice, and then drinking that, and then that will have a much more natural effect. However, this is also temporary, so the best way to cure this overall is to find a way to eat properly and not eating while hungry, and to use water as a snack ultimately. This is the best way to do it.
In the meantime then, that potato water or rice water, it absorbs the acid, so it becomes comfortable. So we have come to the conclusion of what we wanted to present to you, and we have presented this system of how you can change this bad habit, change your digestive system, change your life, get at the root cause of the fermentation which causes disease, get at the root cause of the negative bacteria that comes out of fermentation, so that your body will become freer, lighter, more flexible, disease-free. And in coming videos, we are going to be explaining other ways. As I said, in the next video, we're going to be talking about water drinking, which sounds so simple, but there is real system to it, and you can adapt with that as well. It will make enormous difference. For me, one of the biggest diseases of my life when I was much younger, only drinking water systematically cured it. And it is shockingly simple. So please try this system if you can. Give us a comment of how you feel about the idea below the YouTube video. Ask your questions. We will do our very best to reply to you. And if you really feel that this is beneficial for you, I hope that you will share this video and like this video with others, so that will become a service. Thank you very, very much. And Ramesh, I've enjoyed doing this together with you. Thank you, and namaskar.